faculty in Kolkata School in Tarapathri. We know very well all of the students. In previous video, we discussed, we introduced quarterly interval. So first of all, polygons, unrelated problems completed. Next, quadrilateral, unrelated problems also completed students. Now we are going to types of quadrilaterals. Types of quadrilaterals, students. Okay? Observe here carefully. How many types are there? So types of quadrilaterals. Observe carefully here. I thought this is part 3 video. First we discuss polygons, related problems, next quadrilateral and related problems also completed. Now part 3 quadrilateral, types of quadrilateral, students. So how many types are they? Observe carefully. First of all, what about quadrilateral? Yes, a simple closure figure bounded by four line segments are called a quadrilateral. Sum of all angles in a quadrilateral is 360 degrees or four right angles. Then how many sides, vertices and angles along with diagonals are there in a quadrilateral? We discuss again. I repeat again. So sides, number of sides equal to 4, number of diagonals equal to 2, number of vertices equal to 4 and number of angles equal to 4 also. Okay, students? Right. And again, quadrilateral divided into means 6 types, students. Means types of quadrilateral. First one, observe carefully. Number 1, trapezium. And again, second one, parallelogram. And third one, rectangle. And fourth one is rhombus. And also fifth one is square. And sixth one, kite, students. So kite. Observe carefully, here it is. We are showing on a tree diagram also, students. Observe carefully, tree diagram. So first of all, we have taken quadrilateral. And also its types we are showing on a tree diagram like this. So first type, it is trapezium. And second one, so parallelogram like this, right, students? In short, no problem at all. Parallelogram. And third one is kite, like this, students. Okay. And so in from parallelogram also we are showing like these students. So one is rectangle, other one is rhombus. Okay, from these also we are taken square. Yes, observe students here. Quadrilateral divided into 6 types: trapezium, parallelogram, rectangle, rhombus, square, and also kite. And showing on a tree diagram like this, students, trapezium, parallelogram, and also kite. Parallelogram also here divided into like this, students. Why? Because of from parallelogram also we defined rectangle, and also rhombus, and also square. Yes, in a square we are defining either parallelogram, rectangle, and also a rhombus also, students. So what we conclude about this means, here observe, every trapezium is a parallelogram, is it right? No. Every parallelogram is a trapezium. Right. Means every rectangle is a parallelogram, every rhombus also a parallelogram, every square also a parallelogram. Next one. Here observe, students, every square is a rectangle. And every square is a rhombus. Every square is a rhombus. But converse need not to be a true. Converse need not to be a true, students. Next, there is no any other quadrilaterals are included in a kite students. These are very very important. So write down here. Then we discuss about what is the trapezium and related properties and related problems. Next, what is parallelogram? And also remaining students, definition, properties and related problems also. Yes, first one is first type of a quadrilateral, that is a trapezium students. How to define a trapezium? Observe carefully. A quadrilateral in which one pair of opposite sides are parallel is called a trapezium. Yes, I got here students definition, and write your notebook and learn carefully students. Right, a quadrilateral. So quadrilateral we can express in simple form students like this QDL taken. QDL pronounced as quadrilateral. So a quadrilateral in which one pair of opposite sides. One pair of opposite sides are parallel. One pair of opposite sides are parallel is called a trapezium. Is called a trapezium. Okay, students. Yes, example. Observe the diagram carefully. That's why here quadrilateral ABCD is a trapezium. Is a trapezium. Observe carefully, students. Here quadrilateral, use the symbol, this symbol also, students. Quadrilateral ABCD. AB parallel to CD. AB parallel to CD. That's why. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is a trapezium. Is a trapezium. Okay, students. So here next, BC and AD are the adjacent sides. BC and AD are adjacent sides, friends. Yes, here we discuss one more important quality. Suppose we draw a diagram, the diagram like this. P, Q, R, S. So a quadrilateral. If it is showing a parallelogram, showing a trapezium, must be taken one pair of opposite sides are parallel. So here PQ is parallel to SR. That's why PQ or S is a trapezium. Here observe the adjacent side, that is QR and also PS. If it is adjacent sides are also equal, then the trapezium is called as isosceles trapezium. Isosceles trapezium. Here observe carefully. Trapezium PQRS. Trapezium simply written as trap. Trapezium PQRS. Trapezium PQRS. And PQ is parallel to RS. And RQ, RQR. QR equal to PS. QR equal to PS. That means adjacent sides are equal. Then the trapezium is called as isosceles trapezium. Okay, therefore PQRS is a isosceles trapezium. Isosceles trapezium. So this is the definition. One example. One more important definition of trapezium. Next, one important property is there, students. So observe this one. Or take any one, students, no problem. Okay, I take here ABCD trapezium. Here observe, both are parallel to each other and AD and BC are transversals. AD and BC are transversals. Okay, students? Right. So we know that observe these angles. Both angles are same side of a transversal, and this side also. This side also. Is it clear? Okay. Yes, I explained. In a trapezium ABCD, AB parallel to CD, then angle A plus angle D equal to 180 degrees and angle B equal to angle C equal to 180 degrees. We learn in lifetime angles chapter. So angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. Okay students, by using that important axiom or important point. So here, in a trapezium ABCD, angle A plus angle D equal to 180 degrees. And angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degrees. But observe here, friend. What about A and B? A and B are both are adjacent angles or consecutive angles. What are maybe students? So here, angle A plus angle B is not 180 degrees. Why? Because of here, what we have given parallel sides and transversal concept with composer student here. But in a trapezium, angle A plus angle B is not equal to 180 degrees. Not equal to 180 degrees and angle C plus angle D is not equal to 180 degrees. So, okay, in ABC trapezium, angle A plus angle D and angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degrees. Then we are discussing some related problem. Right, observe the problem carefully. In a trapezium ABCD, AB is parallel to CD. If angle A equal to 50 degrees, angle B equal to 70 degrees, find angle C and angle D students. First, we draw a trapezium aside. So, AB parallel to CD also given. So, AB is parallel to CD. Okay, students? Right. Next one. Angle A equal to 50 degrees given. And also angle B equal to 70 degrees. Yes, I will explain why the definition of a trapezium. Observe carefully here. So, both are parallel to each other and AD is a transversal. Observe carefully, angle A and angle D are angles on the same side of a transversal. That means, angles on the same side of a transversal are supplementary. That is, angle A plus angle D equal to 180 degrees. By using that concept, we can get angle D. And angle B plus angle C equal to 180, you can get C also, student. Comes to the solution carefully. Solution given. In a trapezium ABCD. So, AB parallel to CD. Must be written, students, here it is. Next one. Angle A plus angle D equal to 180 degrees. Angle A plus angle D equal to 180 degrees. Since aside, angles on the same side of a transversal, angles on the same side of a transversal, angles on the same side of a transversal. So angle A value 50 degrees. Therefore, 50 degrees plus angle D equal to 180 degrees plus 50 transfer ratio becomes minus. So then that implies angle D equal to 180 minus 50 becomes 130 degrees. 130 degrees. This is angle D value, students. And same procedure, apply this concept, then angle B plus angle C equal to 180 degrees. And then 70 plus angle C equal to 180. So plus 180 transfer right side becomes minus. Then angle C equal to 110 degrees. 110 degrees. Then observe carefully. We know that already sum of all angles in a trapezium equal to 360 degrees. Okay. So 110 plus 130, 240 degrees. 240 plus 50, 290. 290 plus 70 becomes 360 degrees. This is the solution for given problem, students. Next, we discussed about parallelogram. So how to define parallelogram? Okay, students. And related properties also. Right. Observe carefully, all of you. parallelogram. This is the second type of a quadrilateral. So simply written as like this, students. Simply written as like this. This is parallelogram. It means parallelogram. Okay. Then definition of the students. In a quadrilateral in which two pairs of opposite sides are parallel, is called a parallelogram. I wrote here, students, definition. A quadrilateral in which two pairs of, or both pairs, what it may be, students, two pairs of opposite sides are parallel. Opposite sides are parallel. Is called a parallelogram. Observe, friends, I take one quadrilateral. So I take one quadrilateral A, B, C, and also D, student. AB is parallel to CD and BC is parallel to AD. BC is parallel to AD. Then the quadrilateral ABCD is called a parallelogram. Here one pair, here also other pair, student. So two pairs are parallel to each other. That's why ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, students. Right. Here in that, from the figure, AB is parallel to CD and BC is parallel to AD. Therefore, quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Then we discuss about important properties, students. Important properties, right? Select these, students, all of you. Opposite sides are equal. Okay, that is the first quality, student. Here, in the definition, opposite sides are parallel. But in the property, yes, we proved in the theorem also, students. We discussed here only, right? Opposite sides are equal, first one. And second one, opposite angles are equal. And third one, adjacent angles. A and B are adjacent angles. A and D also adjacent angles. Next, B and C are adjacent angles. B and C also adjacent angles. And C and D also adjacent angles. So adjacent angles are supplementary. That is 180 degrees, students, here. Adjacent angles are supplementary or 180 degrees. And fourth one, observe carefully. Diagonals. In a parallelogram, diagonals are not equal. In this ABCD parallelogram, which are diagonals? I explained in the starting, students, what is the definition of a diagonal. Yes, what is the definition? Yes, observe, friends. A line segment joining opposite vertices of a quadrilateral is called its diagonal. So here, in this parallelogram, AC and BD are diagonals. AC and BD are diagonals. So observe here, diagonals are not equal, but bisect each other. So both are intersect at O, then here OD equal to OB, OA equal to OC, students. OA equal to OC. That means what we conclude here, diagonals are not equal. bisect each other. Bisect each other. That is the fourth property, students. On fifth one. Okay? So, here are the students. Here, I draw one diagonal. That is AC, students. Here, AC divide a parallelogram into two congruent triangles. Two congruent triangles. How it is? Observe carefully, students. I take triangle ABC and also ADC. AB equal to CD. Is it it or? Next, BC equal to AD. And AC equal to AC, common sign. Okay? By using this, both are congruent to each other. So, what we conclude about in this property means, a diagonal divides a parallelogram into two congruent triangles. Two congruent triangles. So, diagonal divides a parallelogram into two congruent triangles. Okay, students. Next, the fifth one. If you draw another diagonals also, then observe here all triangles are congruent to each other. All triangles are congruent to each other. So here diagonal only. Here diagonals. Two diagonals divides a parallelogram into four congruent triangles. Four congruent triangles. So here two diagonals divides a parallelogram into four congruent triangles. Four congruent triangles, students. These are the properties of a parallelogram. I repeat, students. Opposite sides are equal. Opposite angles are equal. Here opposite angle means angle A equal to angle C. Angle B equal to angle D. Okay. Opposite side means AB equal to CD and BC equal to AD. And third one. Adjacent angles are supplementary. That is angle A plus angle B equal to 180. Angle B plus angle C 180. Angle C plus angle D 180. Angle D plus angle E also 180 degrees, friends. Next one. Diagonals are not equal, but bisect each other. Next one. Diagonal divides a parallelogram into two congruent triangles. Next, we are taking two diagonals. So, two diagonals divides a parallelogram into four congruent triangles. Four congruent triangles. This is the information about properties of a parallelogram, friends. Then we discuss about related problems. Yes. In a parallelogram ABCD, angle A equal to 80 degrees, find the remaining angles, students. So, solution given, observe carefully. After analyzation of a problem, first aside, draw a diagram, students. Rough diagram. Here what they given, ABCD is a parallelogram. So, okay. Right. Angle A, 80 degrees, students. Angle A, 80 degrees. Here, we know that, observe two properties. We using two properties, then we solve this problem, students. First one is, here, we know that opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles are equal. So, first one, in a parallelogram ABCD, opposite angles are equal. That means here, angle A equal to angle C, angle B equal to angle D. We don't know angle B value, friends. We don't know angle B value. That's why, so first we find angle B value, friends. So, first this means adjacent angles are supplementary, is better. Adjacent angles are supplementary, means 180 degree. That means angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degrees. Angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degrees. So, from the figure, angle A value 80 degrees given out. So 80 degrees plus AB equal to 180 degrees, isn't it? Yes, plus AB transfer right side becomes minus. Therefore, AB equal to 100 degrees. AB equal to 100 degrees. Okay, students. Next one. Use second property, students. What is that? Opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles are equal. So then here, angle A equal to angle C. Angle A equal to angle C. What about angle A value? 80 degrees. 80 degrees. Next, angle B equal to angle D. Already we find B value. How much value here? 100 degrees. So here, angle A is 80, angle B 100, angle C 80, angle D 100 degrees students. Okay? This is the solution for given problem. Observe the solution carefully, students. Here, first analyze the problem. To understand the angles of a parallelogram are x degrees and 2x plus 30 degrees. So, find x degrees and angles of a parallelogram, students. So, rough diagram drawn aside. So, in a parallelogram, so x degrees, students, and also 2x plus 30 degrees. Both are adjacent angles. Okay, right. So, first you use adjacent angles are supplementary in a parallelogram. Okay, friends? So, in a parallelogram, adjacent angles are supplementary, that is 180 degrees. Therefore, x degrees plus 2x plus 30 degrees equal to 180 plus 30 transfer ratio becomes minus. So, x plus 2x, that is 3x degrees equal to 150 degrees. So, 3 ones, 350s. X degrees equal to 50 degrees spread. So, we find x degrees square. Isn't it our next one? Therefore, here, in opposite angles are supplemental. Sorry, opposite angles are equal in a parallelogram. First, we find 2x plus 30 degrees also spreads. Therefore, 2x plus 30 degrees. 2x plus 30 degrees equal to 2 into x value 15. 2 into 15 plus 30 degrees. It becomes 52 is 100. 100 plus 30, 130 degrees students. 130 degrees. Isn't it or not? So, this is 50. Automatically this angle is also 50. This is 130. Automatically this angle is also 130 degrees. Why? Because of in a parallelogram opposite angles are equal. So, finally, what we conclude that, therefore, angles of a parallelogram are 50 degrees, 130 degrees, 50 degrees, 130 degrees. This is the solution for given problem. Okay, and we go for third problem. Okay, adjacent angles of a parallelogram are in the ratio 2:3. Find the angle, students. So here, let me consider angles of a parallelogram. Adjacent angles given. Then here, first angle is 2x degrees and second angle is 3x degrees. You know very well, right, students? So solution given in a parallelogram. Ratio of adjacent angles equal to 2:3. First let me consider angles, students. So let me angles are 2x degrees, 3x degrees. Okay, we know that adjacent angles are supplementary in a parallelogram. Therefore, we know that 2x plus 3x equal to 180 students. Then 5x degrees equal to 180. Strike it off. X equal to 5 degrees, 15 plus 6 is 30. So 36 degrees students, x value. Then angles, adjacent angles simply. So angles are here 2x degrees equal to 2 into 36, it becomes 2 degrees. Okay. And again, 3x degrees equal to, like 3 into 36, right? This is 8, this is 108 degrees. Therefore, angles in a parallelogram are 72, 108. That's right. This is the solution for given problem. Right here, adjacent sides given straight. So, adjacent sides of a parallelogram. This is 5 centimeters and this is 7 centimeters. In a parallelogram, observe the property opposite sides are equal. This is 5, this is also 5. Here 7, this is also 7. Therefore, perimeter means nothing but sum of all lengths of a diagram. Sum of all lengths of a diagram. So, in a parallelogram, perimeter equal to, that is 5 plus 7 plus 5 plus 7. So, finally, 12 plus 12, isn't it? So, that is 24 centimeter. This is the solution for given problem. Parallelogram ABCD, what is the values of angle A plus angle B and angle A minus angle C? So here, use two properties students here, properties of a parallelogram. So here we are adjacent angles. We know that adjacent angles are supplementary. What about angle A plus angle B? Angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degrees. Angle A plus angle B equal to 180 degrees. We use the adjacent angles concept. Next one. And after students, what is the relation among A and C means? Both are opposite angles. So opposite angles are equal. Therefore, opposite angles are equal. Opposite angles are equal. Therefore, angle A equal to angle C. Plus angle C transfer left side becomes minus. Angle A minus angle C equal to how much value? 0 degrees. This is the solution for given problem, students. Remaining, we discuss next video, students.